In this video, we will cover the autofitting tool group. Let's do a quick overview of how autofitting is used. The donor or original avatar must have a fitting suit which will result in any garment made and saved on that avatar to also obtain a matching garment fitting suit or fitting suit data. That allows you to easily apply that garment to any other avatar as long as that avatar has a fitting suit. Let's get started with the steps to begin using the autofitting tools. Your avatar will first need a fitting suit to use the tools. Let's see what that looks like. The default avatars found in the library come with fitting suits already. We will use them for this example. First of all, let's bring in my avatar by going to the Avatar folder, Avatar version 2, and double-clicking on my avatar to bring her into the workspace. I actually have the View Avatar Fit Suit feature turned on, and we can see that the black mesh indicates that she has a fitting suit. To toggle on and off this fitting suit viewer, go up to the 3D display window, Avatar Options, and you can choose the Show Avatar Fitting Suit, toggling on and off to see if she has one. Here we can see that she does have one. Most people work with custom avatars, so you will have to apply a fitting suit to your avatar to use these tools. There are two ways to apply a fitting suit to an imported avatar. The first one is using the Auto Apply option. Choose either OBJ or FBX file types for this. I'm choosing a custom item in my library, and I'm right-clicking it to add to my workspace, making sure it's Import OBJ. Load type is open. Object type is avatar, and then I can see automatically add arrangement points. Then beneath that, we have the auto create fitting suit. Check that box to use this feature. Sticking with the default scale, millimeters for me, make sure your avatar is going to be the correct scale for import. If you have questions about what scale your avatar should be in Marvelous Designer, see our Tips and Tricks Avatar Too Small or Avatar Too Large video. Select OK to import your avatar with a fitting suit and arrangement points. My OBJ is now brought into the scene, and I can toggle on the Show Avatar Fitting Suit option to see that this auto-applied fitting suit was applied to the avatar. I could move on from here if I wanted. First was auto-create, next is manually create fitting suit using the Create Fitting Suit tool. You can import your file from the library folder itself, or you can choose the File, Import, OBJ, or FBX, and select the file type. I will right-click the library and choose Add to my workspace, toggling off the Auto Create Fitting Suit option for this example. Click OK to import, and with the avatar imported, I will check that she does not have a fitting suit right now, toggling on and off the Show Avatar Fitting Suit. We can see she does not have one. The Create Fitting Suit option is great for if the Auto Create Fitting Suit doesn't really work for your avatar for any reason upon import, or you prefer to do it manually. The fitting tools are located in the 3D window toolbar. I am popping out the tool group so that you can see them. It looks like an avatar with rings around it. Select Create Fitting Suit, and it will pop up a Save File prompt. Save your file if you have not yet done so. This tool will delete all cloth from the scene to allow you to manually create a fitting suit. If you have cloth in the scene, save your work to not lose any of your progress. Your work cannot be recovered, and your cloth history will be deleted if you choose to proceed. I have nothing here on her, so I'm going to go ahead and choose No. Here we have the fitting suit pop-up window with symmetry turned on and reference lines listed. When symmetry is turned on, we will be applying the reference lines to the screen left arms and legs, not the screen right arms and legs. You will see a highlighted ring on the correct side and area indicated as we move through the list. When creating the fitting suit, we start with the upper neck first. So we are going to use this tool to draw 3 points on that neck with a single left mouse click, and that will create the first reference line. Lower neck next. Now, these will be the reference lines for resizing everything, so keep in mind how something may have been made, or how you made something before, and where that waistline, for example, may have been on the previous avatar. As you do your reference lines, try to keep these centered items as parallel to the ground as you can. You can see here it's a bit angled upwards towards the front. To fix that, I go back to the waist by clicking the name in the menu, and then redrawing it like so. And the new line replaces the old. Next is her left wrist. We can see that as the left wrist is highlighted in the pop-up window, it is on the screen left. Please note again that this is going to be the screen direction, not the worn direction. Let's finish the screen left arm reference lines. Keep making these reference lines approximately where the joints are or should be, depending on the avatar that you have. Here with her upper thigh, I made a mistake. I can hit the Escape key to undo that line and start over again before completing it. With this avatar, I am trying to keep the reference lines as parallel to the ground as I can, although it depends on your avatar, how they're styled, how they're standing. Having reference lines parallel to the ground may not work best for that avatar, so keep in mind how they're standing and how you want these garments to lay on these avatars. Once you're done, you will see floating gray patterns in the 3D window. If you made any clear mistakes, you can fix your work by selecting the name to redo the reference line. Once you are done, hit Apply, and it will place a red transparent suit on the avatar. You can pull on this suit and adjust it if necessary, especially if there are any collisions with the avatar mesh itself. Once you are done adjusting the suit, go ahead and click Save. This will prompt a Save As for an AVT file type or avatar file. Here the window is prompting the original location for my previous avatar. I will save it here in this folder for now, giving it a new name and then pressing Save. Exiting the Create Fitting Suit menu, I had left on the View Avatar Fit Suit, and I can see the black mesh fitting suit is still there. This is the new AVT file. You do not need to reopen it. From here on, you can continue working and building cloth in the scene on this avatar. Now that your avatars have fitting suits, you can use them to apply fitting suits to garments, which is next. To apply fitting suits to cloth assets, you simulate the assets on an avatar with a fitting suit. Once you've brought all of your cloth or garments into the scene, go ahead and simulate them on an avatar using the Simulate button or the spacebar. Once you're happy with how it is placed on the avatar, go ahead and save by going to File, Save As, Project, or Garment, whichever you prefer. You can only apply fitting suit data if you save after simulating. Now that your garment is saved, you can double check that it has a fit suit by going up to the 3D display window, Garment Options, and you can see a Show Fitting Suit option. Here you can see it has a red mesh fitting suit, compared to the avatar's black one. This means it was saved correctly and you now have fit suit data for your garment. Next, onto the Retarget Draping tool. Retarget Draping is also in the 3D window under the Fitting Tool group. Make sure your garment has a fitting suit before you try to use it. We can see this item has one. Otherwise, you will get an error message. See the troubleshooting section. Bring in an avatar with a fitting suit into the workspace, along with the intended garment. I will choose Hannah for this one. Hannah is one of our default avatars. She's under the Stylized folder, and she already comes with a fitting suit. Once you have a garment with a fitting suit and an avatar with a fitting suit in the same scene, you can then use the Retarget Draping tool by selecting it once. Once the tool's process is done, we can see that the garment has been placed on the avatar in the 3D window. And there have been no changes to the garment in the 2D window. This is exactly what we want to see when using this tool. This is very convenient for placing larger items on top of smaller avatars. In this case, the hoodie is now an oversized sweater dress on our little avatar Hannah here. If you like how the result is fitting on your avatar, you can save this now as a different file. To apply the new fitting suit to the garment, simulate first on the new avatar and then save. Making sure to save this as a new file if you don't want to overwrite the previous one that you were using. Using the Autofitting tool. The Autofitting tool lives in the 2D window toolbar. When you select the tool, a pop-up will appear with a couple of settings. They are Maintain Graphic Size, and I don't have any graphics in my scene, but sometimes you do want to allow the graphics to scale with your garment. If you have any graphics on your garment, you can toggle this option on if you so choose. Then Maintain Pattern Curvature. We recommend keeping it at 100% when first starting off with this tool. This helps prevent severe warping of your garment, which is dependent upon the difference between the original fitting suit and the new one. Especially if you have a lot of straight lines like I do on this sweater. The lower the percentage, the more it will warp to accommodate the fitting suit of the new avatar, no matter the severity of shape. For now, let's start with 100% to keep it as consistent as we can. This sweater was one example. Let's go ahead and pick another garment, such as a dress. Again, with these tools, you will always need to have your avatar have a fitting suit and your garment to have a fitting suit. We can see the red garment fitting suit, and we can toggle on to make sure that Hannah has her black fitting suit on. After confirming that, we can move forward. Now, when I click the Autofitting button again, I do see a note here that says to change particle distance to 20 millimeters. Let's make sure we do that. Using Ctrl+A to select all of the cloth that is in the scene and looking at the property editor, I can see that we do have some 5 particle distance pieces. With all the pattern pieces selected, I will change the number in the dialog box to 20 particle distance. The reason for this is that Autofitting will do a couple processes at once. It will both retarget drape and it will change the size and shape of the garment to fit the avatar's fitting suit more closely. By bringing this up to 20 particle distance, it will reduce the processing load on your computer and increase the speed at which this process can be completed. After changing the particle distance, I will go ahead and hit OK. As autofitting is running, it can take a bit of time because it is doing those multiple steps all at once. And it is done. Spinning around, you can see that this dress is placed on my avatar, Hannah. But if I zoom in on the garment, you can see it's not completely on her yet. There is some visible space between the pieces. This is because we have not yet simulated the garment on the avatar to allow it to settle into place. After simulating, the reshaped dress is now on her, and I can just toggle off the fitting suit viewers to make it easier to see. In the 2D window, we can see that it did warp a little bit from the original shape, like we expected it to. Keep that in mind. Autofitting is a great tool to solve resizing, but it does not get you 100% of how you may want it to look. Always expect some cleanup and editing after using it. Making adjustments and fixes is to be expected. Thank you for watching the autofitting tutorial. Please let us know what other tutorials you would like to see in the comments section below.